Welcome to our English class. Myself Vidya Lohar from Sri Ram Madhyamik Vidya Mandir Padel, Taluka Devgarh, District Sindhudurga. Dear students, today we are going to learn the remaining part of the story, The Boy Who Broke the Bank. I have divided the story in three parts. And today we are going to see the last, means third part of the story. So, open your book, page number 52, second paragraph. By noon, the small bank had gone through all its ready cash and the harassed manager was in a delay. Emergency funds could only be obtained from another bank some 30 miles distance. And he wasn't sure he could persuade the crowd to wait until then. And there was no way of contacting said Govindram on his houseboat in Kashmir. The People Nagar Bank, it was a small bank and it had gone through all its ready cash. It had to face many problems regarding the cash. And so the manager was also harassed. He was in a difficult situation. He could not understand what to do because emergency funds could only be obtained from another bank, and another bank was some 30 miles distance, and he wasn't sure he could persuade the crowd. It was very difficult for the manager to persuade the people and to wait until then. And there was no way of contacting said Govindram, who was on his houseboat in Kashmir. It was impossible for him to contact said Govindram because he was on his houseboat in Kashmir. People were turned back from the counters and told to return the following day. They did not like the sound of that. When the people are told to come the next day, they become furious. And they want their money instantly. So they gathered outside on the steps of the bank, shouting, "Give us our money or we will break in." And Fetch said, "We know he is hiding in a safe deposit locker." Mischief makers who didn't have a paisa in the bank joined the crowd and aggravated their mood. Their manager stood at the door and tried to placate them. He declared that the bank had plenty of money but no immediate means of collecting it. He urged them to go home and come back the next day. When the people became furious, they gathered outside on the steps of the bank shouting, "Give us money." People demanded their money. They want their money instantly. And so some of them threatened to break into the bank. And some of them also asked to bring said Govindram. And there were some mischief makers also. They also aggravated the crowd. And the manager tried to placate them. Manager tried to tell them not to become furious. But they did not listen at all. The manager declared that the bank had plenty of money but no immediate means of collecting it. The manager tried to convince them that the bank had enough money, but they were not in the condition to listen to the manager. He urged them to go home and come back the next day. The manager requested them to go home and come back the next day. "We want it now," chanted some of the crowd. "Now, now, now." People want their money instantly. And a brick hurtled through the air and crashed through the plate glass window of the People Nagar Bank. Someone from the crowd hits a brick towards the bank and it crashed through the plate glass window of the People Nagar Bank. The annoyed people devastated the bank. Nathu arrived next morning to sweep the steps of the bank. He saw the refuse and the broken glass and the stones cluttering the steps. Raising his hands in a gesture of horror and disgust, he cried, "Hooligans, sons of donkeys." as though it isn't bad enough to be paid late. It seems my work has also to be increased. He smote the stairs with his broom, scattering the refuse. Next morning, Nathu arrived to sweep the steps of the bank, and he saw the refuse and the broken glass and the stones cluttering the steps. And he saw the pieces of glass and stone, and he became very angry. He blames the people who have increased his work. "Good morning, Nathu," said the washerman's boy, getting down from his bicycle. "Are you ready to take up a new job from the first of next month? You will have to, I suppose, now the bank is going out of business." Meanwhile, Sitaram, the washerman's son, he also arrived there, and he told Nathu to be ready for a new job from the first of next month. He told Nathu that the bank is now running out of business. "How is that?" said Nathu. "Haven't you heard? Well, you would better wait here until half the population of Pipal Nagar arrives to claim their money." And he waved cheerfully. He did not have a bank account and sped away on his bicycle. "How is that?" said Nathu. Nathu was surprised by knowing the economical condition of the bank. Sitaram told him to wait here until half the population of Pipal Nagar arrives to claim their money, and he waved cheerfully because he did not have a bank account, and he sped away on his bicycle. Nathu went back to sweeping the steps of the bank, muttering to himself. When he had finished his work, he sat down to the highest step to await the arrival of the manager. He was determined to get his pay. Nathu went back to sweeping the steps, and he was muttering to himself. He was talking with himself. When he had finished his work, he sat down on the highest step. He cleaned the steps, and he was waiting for the manager for his salary. He was determined to get his pay. Now he decided to get his pay, to get his salary. "Who would have thought the bank would collapse?" he said to himself, and looked thoughtfully into the distance. "I wonder how it could have happened." Nathu thought himself how the bank went bankrupt